Hello students, today again we continue with the same topic, continuity. Yesterday we could see the conditions for our functions to be continuous. In a graphical system we have seen if a graph can be drawn in a single stretch without lifting your pen or pencil, it's continuous. But in the maths language, when you speak about the continuity, we have learned that the left hand limit should be equal to the right hand limit and the value of the function should be equal to the limits of the function. Three items are needed: left hand limit, right hand limit, and the value of the function. When all these three are equal, we state that the given function is continuous. If one of these, either the left hand limit or the right hand limit or the value of the function makes a change or a difference in the value, then the function cannot be continuous. Based upon this, today we are going to have another example, a beautiful example from this domain. Let's read this question. Discuss the continuity of the function f of x is equal to modulus of x minus 1 at x is equal to 1. This is a mod question. Last year we have seen that f of x is equal to modulus of a function having a special name, that is modulus function. The same meaning, the same name is here again. F of x is a modulus function because there's a modulus symbol. F of x is equal to modulus of x minus 1. We need to check its continuity at the point x is equal to 1. Now, this question when you do, especially think that we cannot draw or sketch a graph without knowing its meaning. So what I'm going to do now, this modulus sign is causing a problem. So we are going to get rid of this modulus sign first. There we have learned that when you remove the modulus sign, the number that we are writing within the modulus sign can be sometimes positive or it can be negative. Both cases now, either it can be now positive or it can be negative. Then what if it is zero? This means there are three different cases in this case of modulus costing. So we are going to re-express this one of this way, as you see on your green board. F of x is equal to, we are putting a large bracket here. Now we are going to split that modulus of x minus 1 like this. X minus 1. When this x minus 1, the one that we write within the braces or the modulus sign, is more than or equal to 0. Which means when this is a positive number, your value will be x minus 1 alone. Then what will happen when this is minus? If something is minus, we are writing down which is less than 0. So then x minus 1 is a negative number. Means internal region is a negative number. We are adding an extra minus. That's the definition of modulus function. When the number is positive, we are merely taking this number. This means we are giving positive sign. Positive of x minus 1. That is x minus 1. If it is a negative value, an extra negative is given. Minus of modulus of x minus 1. Now this special variety, I can say we are going to simplify into the second step. F of x is equal to x minus 1 when x is more than or equal to 1. How do you get it? x minus 1 is more than or equal to 0. This, when I simplify this inequality, x is more than or equal to 1. Same way, when this minus is injected into this bracket, it becomes 1 minus x, that becomes the functional value. And this is happening only when x minus 1 is less than 0, which means x is less than 1. And here you can see that there are three different stages. So once again, we are going to bifurcate. When you bifurcate once again, f of x is equal to x minus 1, when x is more than 1. From here, I take it as x is more than 1, there is one piece. Then the second one, I write it down, but minus x, when x is less than 1, this will change. But here, there is one equality. So we are going to put it down, x minus 1, when x is equal to 1. So we are having some three different values now for the function. One is x minus 1, when x is more than 1. Second, f of x is equal to 1 minus x, when x is less than 1. When f of x is equal to x minus 1, when x becomes 1. Now what we have to do now, this is within x is more than 1. X is more than 1 means this x could be now on the right side of 1. So this will give you now the right hand limit. This is x is less than 1 will give you the left hand limit. So you don't need to ask anybody, you can directly write it down. Something more than is going to be now always the right hand. Something less than will be now the left hand. So this is a right hand limit, left hand limit. So we are going to find the limit of the function. If it is going to be now the right hand, there are two different ways of writing down. The easiest way, like this, limit x tends to 1 plus. 1 plus means right hand. If it is 1 minus, left side of 1. So limit x tends to 1 plus f of x is equal to. Here you can directly give, because this becomes a polynomial function right now. X becomes 1, 1 minus 1, then becomes 0. The right hand limit becomes 0. Similarly, limit x tends to 1 minus, that will give you the left hand limit of the function. Again, here we go for the functional value, 1 minus x, that is 1 minus 1 becomes 0. The left hand limit becomes now 0. Now what the next line is going to be now, the limit extends to 1, f of x. This is your left hand limit, it's your right hand limit. These two limits are really same. So I can put it down, left hand limit is the right hand limit. So the limit of the function remaining to be 0. Now I need to find the value for f of x. So f of x is equal to modulus of x minus 1. You simplify this value, f of 1 will be equal to modulus of minus 1, that is mod 0, that becomes 0. Which means the limit of the function x tends to 1 f of x is equal to f of 1. Once again, the limit means the left hand limit, the right hand limit, the value for the function, all these are having the same values. Therefore, f of x is continuous at the point x is equal to 1. And when you come back tomorrow, revise this particular questions well 2-3 times, and be having more about this mod questions in tomorrow's class. That's all for today.